Eat this!
Yes!
My turn now!
It's down!
Leave it to me!
Right there! Now!
Over here!
Here! Give
over
up!
Here. There's something counting on you, Adol!
A treasure chest!
It's these critters!
My turn
it's
now!
The same species that captured Rakota!
I'm ready for this.
Over here!
Next! Hey! Bring it on! Take this!
The end of the mountain pass.
Yes, we're finally out in the open.
The view is pretty spectacular.
Wow! Beautiful! Though savage at times, this world can be breathtakingly beautiful. Right now, we're seeing the world as it was before humans came into existence. Why this island, though?
Ain't we trying to get to those ruins we saw from the summit?
Yes. We must travel west through these plains to get there. Be on your guard, everyone!
It's enormous. Is this a primordial too?
Yes. It must be a sauropod, the largest species of primordial currently on record.
We can't possibly fight this thing. There's only one, though. Maybe we can run away.
Look!
How many is that now?
Don't shoot it!
Huh?
Primordials eat leaves? Not all primordials are vicious carnivores. They appear to be herbivores, and quite docile despite their enormous size. As long as we don't provoke them, they shouldn't show any signs of aggression.
What a relief. These things would crush us, even with our orichalcum weapons.
Indeed. Adol, let's be mindful not to provoke these creatures as we pass through this area.
It looks even stronger up close!
Must
here we go!
I got stronger again!
It's not over yet!
Leave it to me!
Allow me!
Switch! It's not over yet! It's not over yet! It's not over yet! It's not over yet!
Finally, we can relax.
We haven't had a moment's rest since we arrived on the north side of the island.
Tell me about it. Those giant primordials we saw scared the crap out of me. I mean, they looked scary and all, but they were actually pretty calm.
I was rather surprised by those cute primordials that captured Rakota. The current research does not indicate that there are species with such high intelligence. Perhaps this is the providence of evolution.
Evolution?
It's the process by which a species' traits and characteristics transform over generations.
What do you mean?
Primordials are thought to have been no more intelligent than your average beast. A parent produces offspring, and that offspring will produce offspring of its own. The primordials we saw could have developed intelligence through that process. And that process we call evolution.
Is that really possible?
Well, to be fair, it's not proven, but it is the most popular theory among researchers.
Is it sort of like how a child learns words and starts talking?
That's growth, not evolution. Characteristics passed on through evolution are inherent from birth.
Do you understand this at all?
Yeah.
Man, I don't get it at all. Laxia must be some kind of genius.
If you'd like, I could start over and provide a simpler explanation.
No, that's enough. No more. Please.
Really? What a pity.
What's the matter, Rakota? Feeling sleepy?
What's wrong? Are you not feeling well?
Maybe your lecture bored her to tears.
What?
It's not that. Spending time with you guys has been so much fun. And when I got captured by those primordials, you guys came to save me. Sahad said we're family.
That's right.
I have a father. But all the families in my books have lots more people in them. Comforting, fun, warm. I've always wanted a real family. And you guys make me feel like I'm part of one. So... Huh?
Rakota.
Well, yeah. We are a real family. Laxia over there, she's basically your big sister.
Laxia? My big sister?
That's right.
Adol and Hummel over there, they're sort of like your two big brothers.
Adol and Hummel? I get two big brothers?
Sure, I accept.
And since you already got a dad, I suppose that makes me... Hey, I may be older than you kids, but I ain't that old yet.
I want Sahad to be Sahad. 'Cause you're nice and funny, just like Father.
Isn't that sweet? Why, I think that's the nicest compliment you could ever receive.
You think so?
It's getting pretty late. We should rest up for tomorrow.
Tally-ho!
Another vision? Or was it just a dream? Red hair, like fire. Who was that man? And...
Donna, are you awake?
Yes. Please, come in. Swordsman was on the back road. Going east through the mountain gate might be the fastest way. Feels nice today. The sky is so clear. I can see the entire landscape from up here.
Ah, 'tis the maiden.
Good morning, Your Eminence.
Oh, Dran and Rastel. You're patrolling this route this morning?
I am, at least.
I'm paying close attention to my father, so I can better learn the ropes of being a guard.
And yet you seem to do little more than follow my every step like a needful pup. Your antics are the reason my men disrespect me when they think my back is turned.
Don't worry, Father. I'm just getting some early training in before I actually enlist, that's all.
Same as ever, I see. Huh? Actually... Rastel, have you gotten taller since I last saw you? You haven't stopped growing like a weed since the day you became taller than me. You better slow down soon before you tower over your fellow guards.
That doesn't sound so bad. Just wait, Your Eminence. I'm gonna be a great guard someday. I promise. Once I do, I'll protect you.
Oh my. I look forward to that day. Our elite guards are the pride of this kingdom. I will be watching your career with great interest.
I won't let you down!
Good heavens. My apologies. Please forgive my son. He knows not what he speaks. Do you intend to travel beyond the city limits, Your Eminence? There have been more reports than usual of wild Saurians roaming the roads. I know I need not be concerned for your safety, but do be careful nonetheless.
Thank you, Dran. Blessings of the great tree be upon you.
And blessings to you too, Your Eminence.
Thank you.
Yes! Great job!
Right. I should go where the red-haired swordsman went.